Welcome back. Hope y'all are having a fantastic day, and welcome to a new series that I'm gonna call Spontaneous Short Stories. So generally, the episodes that you guys see have a bit of planning behind them. There's a concept that I have in mind that I wanna put together into a video, but some nights I go out with no plan. I'm not even filming a YouTube video. However, I always carry a GoPro on my helmet, either rolling or ready to roll, just in case something crazy happens, I can flip it on and capture the moment. And sometimes crazy things do happen. And that's the idea behind this spontaneous short story series. That's a lot of S's. So before we get into this footage, if you are looking into getting into paramotoring, enjoying this form of flight, I recommend going to my friends at Aviator Paramotor down in Lake Wales and now Dunellen, Florida. They've got two locations going on. They're booking slots for this summer, so if you want to get into it ASAP, hit them up, get on the schedule. They're one of the biggest, and in my opinion, the best schools in the US. It's where I learned almost 7 years ago now. And little added bonus, if you sign up and you mention that you heard of them from me, I reach out to you and I send you a free t-shirt of your choice from Risky Biscuits Co. So check them out. I'll leave their link in the description. So let's get into the footage. This day started out with really beautiful weather. The winds aloft were a little bit strong, but we had a solid like 2.5 hour window of flyable weather. So me and a bunch of other guys, we set out from an LZ, and like we do a lot of times when there's strong winds aloft, we'll fly into the wind on the beginning of the flight so that later on we can turn around and zip back downwind, no problem, make it home in time before sunset. So all filled up, a lot of gas, we took off, and the first leg of the flight, we climbed over a big hill, over a reservoir, and into the next valley. As we entered the valley, I kind of saw this sweet line down the side of a hill. I've flown this line before, and you can kind of come off power and rip some wingovers down the sides of the trees. I had some sweet music playing in my headphones, and like I said, I was just out having a good time, not really planning on filming anything. So I dropped down the sweet line into the next valley, and this is the valley that I'm most familiar with. I know this valley like the back of my hand. I've logged hundreds of hours flying in this area. But this time I noticed there was an airplane flying around pretty low. He was down in the valley with us. I saw him flying around having a good time, and I kind of made a mental note like, he's down in here with us, keep an eye on him because it doesn't take long for him to get to us. I noticed him do a couple passes over this field. He'd do a pass, hook a 180, come back through the field, and then I saw him kind of heading towards me. So this is when I flipped on my GoPro. Obviously I knew I gotta keep an eye on him. I don't wanna have a collision hazard. So I had a couple bailout options if we ended up on a collision course, but it soon became apparent he saw me and I saw him. As he rounded his turn, I kicked my legs a little bit and he rocked his wings. So that was kind of the, hey, what's up? I see you too. Keeping in mind his wake turbulence, I made a turn down the valley, and sure enough, he does a 360 and loops back around behind me. Now, I have my speed bar set up on my paramotor, which allows me to get up to about 50 miles per hour. And I knew this plane could probably slow down to that range, so as he approached me from behind, I started to accelerate. He knew what I was doing, I knew what he was doing, and we lined up for a little bit of formation. So I held a steady line and he kind of accelerated, got back behind me, and we held a nice safe distance that it didn't present any collision hazard, but he could see me nice and clear. I saw him, we were just hanging out. I thought it was the funniest thing ever.
I don't know where all my friends went. I just freaking blasted at 50 miles an hour over here.
I kept an eye on him, and then I flew back over to my buddy Jeff to be like, yo, did you just see that? That was insane. That was awesome. So Jeff and I are flying together for a little bit, and I look over my right shoulder, and I see him coming on right behind me again. So I line up, get on my speed bar, get up to about 50 miles an hour, and sure enough, he creeps up nice and steady right up next to me again.
Can you imagine? It's like the FAA. All of a sudden I hear like, whoop, whoop, pull over. Well, that's some of those, the most random shit that's ever happened to me. That's gotta be a freaking hilarious sight from the ground. Like seeing a freaking parachute keep up with an airplane, like I'm on a damn rag. Meanwhile, I'm like freaking 15 miles away from home. I probably just burned half a tank of fuel running at full speed to keep up with an airplane.
I've done a lot of this type of flying in the past, so I knew I had bailout options. I could make a lot more distance between us if we ever needed it. And obviously he was pretty comfortable with it as well. He was out there having a good old time. I've seen plenty of planes while flying my paramotor. Some of them, I don't know if they ever saw me, but many of them I know have seen me. They've done the wing rock, they've let out smoke to say what's up, but I've never had kind of an impromptu little get together in the sky with an airplane before. I thought it was hilarious. It was like we were doing a little drag race. Probably looked epic from the sky, like people looking up like, how the hell is that bedsheet guy keeping up with an airplane? So after the second pass, dude man disappeared, and that was the last I saw of him. My buddy Jeff and I linked up again. We flew over the next hill, and we noticed some clouds up above that were just lingering on into the evening. They looked low enough, so we climbed up, and sure enough, we were rewarded with a beautiful sight. The sun was just starting to set, so we got that beautiful yellow glow across the top of the clouds. I took some pictures of Jeff, and him and I speed barred a little bit back home, now with a nice tailwind. Made it back over the reservoir real quick, and we settled down into our LZ again. So this flight was like 10 out of 10 awesome. It had a little bit of everything. We did some high flying, we did some low flying, met up with a random airplane, flew above the clouds. It was just an epic flight. It's what paramotoring is all about. But yeah, it really is incredible that freaking paramotors, little two-stroke butt fans and their bedsheet nylon wings, can cruise 50 miles an hour and keep up with an airplane. It freaking blows my mind. Some people on Instagram were asking me about like wake turbulence. And the thing about wake turbulence is if the airplane's here, as long as I don't go directly behind the airplane, I'm fine. If I'm over here, I'm good. If I'm above, if I'm in front of him, it's all good. I just can't cross paths behind him. Now, as time passes, he leaves wake, which is just swirling air. And that swirling air kind of descends and spreads out to the side. So I kind of have to keep a mental note over time of where he was, kind of like a smoke trail, and just know not to cross paths with that trail again. It's easy enough to do, but it's definitely a good thing to think about in any situation if you're operating near airplanes, that they kick off a decent amount of wake and it can be dangerous to our little fabric wings. Anyways, that's all for this story. If you guys like this concept of short stories, definitely comment and drop a like so I know to do more of them, because I've got a bunch of footage that I can put together into these series. So yeah, drop a like if you liked it. If you wanna grab some sweet paramotor t-shirts, check the first link in the description for our Risky Biscuits Co. merch. And like I said, if you're an aspiring paramotor pilot that wants to get into it, definitely check out Aviator. Fill out the application on the website for training, get on the schedule. They've got availability pretty much right away this summer, so you can make it happen. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. I will see you in the next one. Till then, peace. Zip.